Hello everyone, my name is Ihor July and in this video I'll show you how to unlock all of the games in Nvidia GeForce Now service. While doing that, I found an interesting information that I never expected to find. Nvidia GeForce Now is a cloud gaming service which allows you to stream games which you already own directly from their servers. Sadly, Nvidia needs a permission from game publishers to get their games listed. For instance, such games as GTA and Mafia are not available, many other AAA titles are missing as well. There is a list of officially supported games on their website, but I find out that for some reason there are more games available to run than listed. In the past, old version of Nvidia GeForce Now application has been downloading the file named whitelist.json, which contained a full list of games possible to run. Since it is no longer possible to get this file, I decided to inspect and test is it possible to unlock more games. First of all, you need to download official GFN client application. After I've done that, I can start and install Nvidia GeForce Now. Every time application starts, it downloads a game list information from GFN servers. To be sure that an application created some log files and cache files, let's wait for its content to be fully loaded. Once it's confirmed, just close the application. Let's inspect its data folders by opening the installation location. There were lots of logs, and when you read the console.log file, we can find something interesting. There is a logged configuration of web requests used to fetch a game list. The most interesting is that URL. Let's copy that and open via a web browser. It shows up as GraphQL editor. Let's see what we can do here. GraphQL is an open source data query and manipulation language for APIs. It allows the client to define a structure of the data required, and the same structure of data is returned from the server. And here we can see how the request should look like. A response looks like a JSON formatted structure. Let's try to write some empty request. When I press the play button, a valid error message shows up. When I press Ctrl plus space, I'm getting an intelligent code completion pop-up. Once executed, it shows no error messages, and it says the number of returned rows is 1000. I used apps block and placed it the inner block items, which contains a list of requested fields. Let's complete more fields. As you can see, we can add many fields, including title, short description, and others, so we can get full information about games. I'll add a few more fields, so we can get a complete information on the right side. There is Images block, which contains many other fields for providing information about links, screenshots, and posters. If you keep this Images block unfilled and press play button, it will be automatically filled by brackets, and we can add more information later. Add in the last one, Store IDs, which contains a game store information like Steam or Origin. Now we can see information about the game on the right side and the query on the left side. I will add a screenshot section because I know that it is missing. Now we have a lot of details about the game and screenshot links on the right side. I'll remove some unnecessary fields so the results become more easy to read. We can scroll down to see other games, but we can't get more than 1000 at a time. Let's try to get more results by adding some parameters. I guessed that the argument after is made for seeking rows, so we can get a next rows block. It is a base64 encoded number, which is used as a value for how many rows to skip. There is more than 18,000 games on that results. While here we can see a lot of games, GFN client app is limited to about 1000 only. I created a special proxy server which injects all of the games into the GFN client application, so we can see how it looks like. I have already set up it here. The application is launching and it is loading information not from the GFN's servers, but from my proxy server, which is made to remove a game list limitations. It is working. Let's check out how many games are available here. It is 18,476 games. Plenty of them. Here is one of my favorite, the Mafia game. It was never available on GFN service officially. Looks like it is fully integrated to look nice on GeForce Now service. Later in this video I'll share the instructions so you can set up proxy by yourself. And for now let's check out other sections. NVIDIA added to GFN not only games, but a lot of applications, including Twitch Studio, Photoshop, 3D Max, Maya and other professional graphic tools. You can also find here Microsoft Office and much more. But this is not the most interesting thing here, so let's continue. We can find the client platform section here. It is the most popular game launchers and stores, standalone applications. Most likely NVIDIA uses them for testing and running all of the third-party games without adding them to GeForce Now service. Have a look, it is a God of War, the game which is a PlayStation exclusive, and it says it is located in Steam store, but it is not available in Steam. Here is GTA 5 game, it was never announced on GFN. But on all of those screenshots, it looks like it is ready to play. Uncharted is another PlayStation exclusive, though it is available on GFN servers. And here is possible explanation. You can find a Dolphin emulator on GFN service. It is made to run a pirate copies of games from other platforms. And here another PlayStation exclusives, which may never be presented on other platforms. And here we can find a new Nintendo Switch exclusives. What do you think? Maybe they play pirated copies of those games on emulators? And here is proof. Look closer at this game. It says NVIDIA confidential. Possibly it means NVIDIA wants to hide the fact that they play this game. It looks like ready to play, but focused on those screenshots. It says Super Mario Bros. Wii, which means that the game is for sure made exclusively for Wii U console. So we have two things here. NVIDIA added the game Super Mario Bros. Wii to the GeForce Now service, and they added Dolphin emulator, which is able to launch this game. There is no legal way to copy Nintendo games, and that's why we have no chances to legally launch this game via GeForce Now service. What do you think? Is it considered as piracy? Does NVIDIA illegally use those games? Please write your thoughts in the comments. As promised, I made instructions how to set up the proxy, You can find them on the website gfn.uax.co. Also, I have put the links to the GraphQL editor with already entered script codes in the description into this video. I tried to contact NVIDIA and report that information 4 months ago, but they ignored it. More information about this in video description. Please subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, or if you want me to film more videos like this. Thanks for watching!